Tonight, bounty paper towels, specifically from the Bounty Modern Print Collection. A new search warrant revealing potential trophies that accused serial killer Rex Huerman may have kept that could be key to the murders. The paper towels among them. Now, this is according to the Chester News and Reporter, which has seen the warrant. This is a neighbor of Huerman comes forward tonight, telling News Nation that he heard Huerman digging in his backyard in the early hours of the morning. This comes just one day after investigators told us they believe that Huerman likely committed some of the murders at his home. Jean Casarez is out front.
The guy was odd and strange, but never violent.
Neighbors of suspected serial killer Rex Huerman speaking out about his past behavior. One telling News Nation Huerman dug holes in his backyard. Another saying they remained friendly after a confrontation 28 years ago when Huerman would look over the fence and try to talk to his wife while she was sunbathing.
It happened so many times that finally I pulled him over and said, and we had a talk.
Residents in this Long Island suburb still in shock.
For something like this to happen right under our nose.
As authorities continue to collect and investigate potential evidence, they are now trying to determine if the alleged serial killer may have committed the murders of Melissa Barthelemy, Megan Waterman, and Amber Costello right in his own home. Investigators are combing through Huerman's home, searching for clues, including personal effects linked to the victims.
Every piece of evidence that could be gathered, whether it's from the storage containers or from his home, could be valuable not only to the murders that he's currently being charged with, but more importantly, if we can connect him to other murders.
But it is the forensic evidence from possible victims that will establish the home as the primary crime scene. Documents show authorities believe they already have circumstantial evidence that points to the Long Island home where victims may have been murdered. In 2022, a comprehensive investigation revealed for the first time Huerman used burner phones to arrange dates with the victims. Documents state before each victim went missing, triangulation of cell phone tower data showed the burner phones and the victims' phones traveled to Massapequa, Long Island, at about the same time as Huerman, where his family home was located. They were never seen again. Huerman was charged in the murder of the three women. He has pleaded not guilty. Legal documents also reveal Huerman's wife, Asa Ellerup, was out of town each and every time the three victims were last seen. On Thursday, Huerman's wife filing for divorce from her husband of more than 27 years, her attorney telling CNN in a statement, the sensitive nature of her husband's arrest is taking an emotional toll on the immediate and extended family, especially their elderly family members. Authorities also expanding the investigation, as well as looking to see if Huerman is connected to unsolved homicide cases in Nevada, South Carolina, and New Jersey.
And crime scene processing of that family home will continue this weekend. You know, Aaron, this is one of the longest crime scene processings of a home I've ever seen. They're looking to see if the murders were committed in the home. They have got to find forensics that show that those women, those young women, were in that home. And this all happened in 2009, 2010.